if you go into directdevops.blog, right? So if you get into the Linux classroom notes, I think last class we were basically trying to play with environmental variables, play with environmental variables. Okay, and I have discussed how to set the environmental variables using the startup files. Using the startup files, to be very specific, bash profile and bash underscore profile, right, for the user, okay, or dot bash profile, right? So let us basically continue with okay users and groups in Linux. So this is what we would be doing for today, right? Okay, right. So basically the whole idea over here is we will try to understand how to deal with user editions and how to deal with group editions, how to basically do some of the user management in the case of Linux, right? So we have slightly used this already, okay? So but we would basically get into the actual stuff over here. So Linux user and group management, okay? Right. So let us see what is this whole stuff about, okay? So in Linux, okay, so Linux is a multi-user operating system, yes or no? Linux is a multi-user operating system. We have discussed about it. So obviously when it is a multi-user operating system, we should know how to handle multiple users and how to manage them, how to manage them. So let us basically get started over here, right? So to add a new user account, we have two commands. The first one command is add user. The second command is user add. Okay. Or to be very specific, okay, one of this is actually not a Linux command. One of this is not actually a Linux command. So generally, okay, whenever a user is created, okay, so user gets, okay, he will get username, he will get user ID, okay, he will get home directory, okay, yes. So these are the three basic things which you would basically get, okay. And generally, okay, when we create the username, okay, what would basically happen? Okay, there is one more thing that also gets created. A group is created, okay, for the user with the same name as username. With the same name as username. So let me quickly log in into AWS account. Okay. And let me create two machines, one Red Hat instance and one Ubuntu instance. So there is one machine which is running, I'll shut it down, and then I'll create two machines. So launch instance. Okay. So let me create a Red Hat 8 instance. Okay. And I'll give the name of it as Red Hat. Okay. And I'll be selecting all the ports. Let me open this. So while this machine is under creation, let me launch one more machine. This machine would be Ubuntu server. Okay, I'll call this machine as Ubuntu. Right. So now if you see, we have both the servers which we have created, right? Instance state running. Okay. So if you remember, for Red Hat machines we use PowerShell, and for Ubuntu machines I use Git Bash. Let us use this as a pattern so that I don't need to write about it every time. I don't need to write about it every time. Okay. Yeah. So let me log in into Red Hat machine first. Oh, Red Hat machine. I said I'll be using PowerShell, right? So let me get into PowerShell. My PEM file is in downloads, and then this would take time. Red Hat instance generally takes time. Okay. Yeah. So if you see, this machine is up. Okay. Why it takes time? We need to understand one of the important service that is basically called as SSH service, but we are not there yet. So what you do is, okay. So exercise. Okay. What I would be doing is create a user called as Iron Man. Okay. I've used the same example in create user called as Thor, and create a user called as Hulk. Okay. And for all of these users, I'll be using a different command. For fourth user, I'll be creating a user called as Superman. Okay, these are DC characters. If you know superhero movies, create a user called as Batman, and then create a user called as Wonder Woman. So these are six users. Okay. And then what you do is create a group called as Avengers. Okay. And add Iron Man, Thor, and Hulk to it. Okay. And then create a group called as, okay, Justice League, right? Yeah. Justice League, and add Superman, Batman, and Wonder Woman. Am I clear on this? In your organizations, you might be creating testers, DB admins, okay, desktop users, whatever groups which you are basically interested in. Okay, right. So before we get into this, let's try to understand, okay, difference between user add and add user. So I'll be creating add user test one and user add test two. Okay, so let us experiment that in Ubuntu machine first. Okay, so to add users, you need permissions, you need privileges, and I'm quite sure we know how to get privileges, sudo. Okay, so I'll be trying to tell add user. What is the command? Add user test one. So then it is asking, what is your password? Okay, I'll say test one. Okay, then full name, right? So then sudo user add test two. Okay, it has not added anything now. So what are the differences which you can evidently see straight away? When I use add user, what is it trying to do? It is setting my home directory. It is asking me for password. It is doing all of that. User add doesn't do all of that. User add doesn't do all of that. Okay. So let me take this folders path. Okay. Right. So now let me basically do one more thing. Okay. Cat etc passwd. I have already spoken about what this is. Okay. So are there any differences? Okay, right. So cat etc passwd, and then after that ls slash home. So let me basically do ls slash home. So are you seeing test one? But are you seeing test two folder? Okay. So if I use add user, what is happening? My home directory is creating. Okay. So if you want to look at with permissions, ls hyphen l slash home. So are you seeing there is a folder created for test one with permissions for test one, but test two folder is not created. So if you use user add command, home directory will not be created. You have to create it later. Okay. Yeah. So this is basically what is happening on Ubuntu instance. Okay, let us try to do the same stuff on Red Hat. Okay, so let me add 85, 86 and 87. Review dot slash images slash Linux 85.png 86.png and 87.png. Now I'll do the same stuff in Red Hat instance. Okay. So add user test one. Okay. So I have to use sudo, right? Sudo add user test one. Okay. And sudo user add test two. In this, in both the cases, it has not asked for password. Okay. So in Red Hat machines, you have to set the password on your own. Okay. Right. This is your 88. And after that, cat etc passwd. So here, if you see, there are not much of differences. They look almost the same. They look almost the same. All right. So blue is Red Hat. Understand that. Okay. Now ls hyphen l slash home. Okay. So are you seeing here the directories are created? Okay. So the behavior might change from distribution to distribution. So tomorrow, if you basically go with OpenSUSE might behave differently, right? So let's look at Red Hat. Okay. So eighty-eight, eighty-nine, ninety. Okay. 88, 89, 90. Okay. Now, right? In Linux, there will be no default password, sir. Okay. We can set the password. I have already spoken about setting the password in the class. Set the password to the user. Okay. To the user. Okay. By executing what command? Passwd. Okay. So I can basically say sudo passwd test one. Then it is asking what is the password for test one. Yeah, it is a bad password. I know I am okay with that. Okay. And then sudo passwd test two. Yeah, it says it is bad password. Bad password is because I'm giving very small or easy password. Right? So this is how you create passwords in Red Hat. Okay. In the case of Ubuntu, for one machine, we have created the password already. We have only one user left. We have only one user left. Okay. So that user is test2. So sudo passwd test2. Right. Am I clear on this? The command's behavior might change based out of the distributions what you are using. Okay. So the command is not giving me the same result in Ubuntu, right? And Red Hat instances. Am I clear on that, sir, so far? Yes or no? Yeah. Right. And now, basically, whenever you create the files, what are the different things that happen? Okay, in the home directory. Okay, so let me go into ls or slash home slash test one. So are you saying there are three folders, the three files that are created? Okay. So whenever you look at any folder that is basically being created, okay, we have three files, and I'm quite sure that we know some of the files over here. Okay, dot profile. Yeah, did we come across it by any chance? Look at the Linux file loading order, the init scripts. Yes, good. Right. So there is bash rc and bash underscore logout. Okay, we will find out what bash underscore logout is meant for, but for now let us try to at least make out. Okay, so in the home directory, okay, few hidden files are created. Okay. Now let me try to look into the hidden files in the case of Red Hat machine. Ls hyphen al slash home slash test one. Okay. Yeah, I think I need to. Sorry, saying are the files same? Okay. There will be similarities and there will be dissimilarities across distributions. Okay, 93 and 94. Am I clear on this, sir? Okay, right. Now, if you look into, okay, hc passwd, the entry pattern in this file looks as, okay, the following. So username colon sorry, username colon x colon, right, uid colon gid, right, colon comment colon home directory, okay, colon default terminal colon default terminal, okay, which is basically called as default shell, okay. Now let's look at the example which we have basically got, okay. So cat etsy passwd, okay, okay. So Ubuntu entries, okay. So username is test, okay. So the X over here indicates that the file is protected. There is a password in etsy slash shadow file, okay. UID is user ID, next is user ID, and next is group ID, okay. After that you have to write comment. Comment is not written, so that's where there is basically a comma around there, so they have given commas as comment, okay. And then they are giving the home directory. So what is the home directory? Home directory is home slash test one and home slash test two, right. What is the default slash? Bin slash sh. Now there is one more file. If you look into etsy slash group file, this is a group file, so let me go over here, cat etsy slash group, okay. So over here the format is not that critical, right. The format is, the format for each line is, okay, it starts with group name colon group password colon GID colon group members, okay. Now if you basically go over here, okay, there is no need for you to do copy this. I'll basically do this, copy this, paste it over here, okay. Sample Ubuntu entries. Now if you look at it, is trying to tell that the username is group, x means the password is an etsy slash shadow file, and the group id is basically gid, and right now it is not trying to tell you any users, okay, because the username, there is only one user basically present over here. Am I clear on this, sir? Yeah. So shall we do this exercise now? Now do we understand what is home directory, right? And then in Linux, I have said this already, all of your passwords are stored in an encrypted form in a file which is etsy slash shadow. So the test2 password got encrypted into something which looks like this. Am I clear on this, right? Okay, now shall I do this exercise, create the users called as Iron Man, Thor, Hulk, okay. So what do you think is a better command, using add user or user add? What do you think is a better command, using add user or user add? Okay, add user is a better command all the time because it creates the home directories also. If you don't want home directories, if you want customizations, then use user add, okay. So I'll be creating add user Iron Man. Okay, sorry man. So for this you can add as a root user or with a pseudo user. Okay. Okay, then sudo add user Thor. Right, and then sudo add user what was Hulk. Right, so did I add the users? Yeah, let me take the screenshot of this. Okay, I'm not going to show you all the commands because we have already done this in the classroom. I am hopeful that you guys will be able to do this. Okay, right, so exercise, okay, 9th, some screenshots, okay, right, 95. I want you to do this activity, review.slash/images/linux95.png, right. Okay, right, now I have to add basically a group. Okay, so for the adding the group also we have two commands. Okay, or we have one command which is called as group add. So sudo group add Avengers. Okay, and then I want to add the users to the group. For this I have already said you the command, the user mod, sudo user mod hyphen ag. Okay, group's name is Avengers and the user which I want to add is Iron Man and then Thor and then Hulk. Okay, I am doing only on Ubuntu instance. Okay, so similarly can you do the same stuff for the other group which is Justice League, which is Justice League. Okay, so Nazir, basically is this your first class by any chance? Sir, every day the classroom notes is basically shared to you over here, right? Okay, so why else do you want my Visual Studio code, sir? Yeah, okay, whatever I'm writing here I'm sharing it over here, sir, right, sir? So have you ever seen any faculty sharing the whole notes? No, please understand that. Okay, focus on Linux, sir. I'm sharing whatever I'm trying to do. Okay, right, sir. Now can we basically go ahead and then create we have created Avengers. Similarly, can you create Justice League in both Red Hat and Ubuntu systems? Commands are same, there is no difference. Okay, so I'll simply write, right, for group management. Okay, there are three commands. One is group add, the other one is group del, the other one is user mod. Okay, group del will delete the group. Group del will delete the group. Am I clear on this, sir? Let us assume that now this is where I want to basically come to. Okay, right? So this is something which we will be basically discussing anyway, right? So how can I give pseudo permissions to my users? Okay, so I'm just giving you a hint. In Ubuntu, if you basically go into groups, /group. Okay, so are you seeing a group over here? Yeah, so what is that group's name? Okay, in Ubuntu we have a group called as sudo. If you add users to this sudo group, they can execute sudo commands. And I'm quite sure we have discussed what sudo is. Yes or no, sir? Sudo will just, okay, elevate your privileges for only this command, for only the command which you are trying to execute. Okay, that is good in Ubuntu. How about Red Hat? Let us look into it. So /etc/group. Okay, so where is that? Yeah, are you saying this group? What is this group's name? What is that group's name which I have highlighted, sir? Wheel. Yeah, so in the case of Red Hat based machines, if you want pseudo privileges, right? So in RHEL family, let it be Red Hat, CentOS or Fedora, okay, we have a group called as wheel. Adding users to this wheel group, okay, can enable users to execute sudo commands. So for example, okay, now let us assume that I will switch myself as su. Okay, I have not created over here, right? So su, okay, now if I get into my home directory, okay, and now if I say sudo apt-get update, okay, it will ask for password of this. Okay, so what is it trying to tell? Iron Man is not in the sudoers file. Iron Man is not in the sudoers file. Now let me not do that. Let me do the whole screenshot. Now what I'll try to do is I'll try to exit and then I'll try to sell sudo user mod -ag to the sudo group, add the user called as Iron Man, and then let me switch myself as a user Iron Man. Okay, now let me execute sudo apt-get update. Is it working, sir? Okay, why it is working now? Because I have added the user called as Iron Man to a group called as sudo. Okay, all right, let me try to take the screenshot from here. Are you clear on this? Yeah, if you want to do the same thing on a Red Hat flavor, what will be the group to which you will add your information to add your user? You will add your user to the wheel group. You will add your user to the wheel group. Am I clear on this, sir? Will you be able to do that? Okay. 97, I know. What is 98? Okay. 98. Okay. All right. So adding a user Iron Man to pseudo group. Is it fun, sir? Now do you understand how the user gets the pseudo permissions? Okay, so by default, when we log in as a user in Ubuntu machine, that machine you are able to execute sudo commands because it is already part of sudo group. It is already part of sudoers group. Right? So there is one more thing which I need to basically speak about, which is VA sudo and pluggable authentication modules, but that we will discuss in our next class. Okay.
Thanks for watching. For more videos, subscribe our channel and click on bell icon.